A Trainz asset needs 6 files. The 3 texture files we created with PBR Painter, diffuse, parameters, and normal. The FBX file we created in Blender, containing the modeling information. A thumbnail image for display in N3V Games Content Manager, the game's Surveyor mode, and in the game's Download Station, which we will create shortly, and a config.txt file that is generated by Trainz when we create a new asset. We linked the 3 texture files to the FBX file using PBR Painter. By opening the config.txt file shortly, we will link the FBX file and the thumbnail file and add other information needed to generate the finished Trainz asset. The thumbnail file can be a simple JPEG file. It must be 240 pixels wide and 180 pixels high. If you don't have a suitable image of the asset, you can create a generic file, then replace it with an image you may want to take after you have imported the asset into Trainz. The generic file can be created in GIMP. Open GIMP and add a new image. File menu and select New. Make the image 240 pixels in width and 180 pixels in height and select OK. Zoom in on the image. Keyboard shortcut Command plus scroll. Select the text tool and set the font size to 48. Add the word generic. You can center the text by selecting it and with the keyboard shortcut Alt plus drag. Save your file by selecting the file menu, then export as, and name the file thumbnail. Select JPEG format and export. We are now ready to assemble the Trainz asset. I'm going to make the asset compatible with Trainz 2019 and newer versions. That is, using a Trainz build of 4.6. Open Trainz in the Content Manager window. From the filters in the Content Manager window, select Today. In the Developer menu, select New Content to create a new asset. Select the new asset and right mouse button and select Reveal in Finder. You will see the config.txt file that Trainz has created in the folder. Copy your texture files into the folder. Diffuse.png, parameters.png, and normal.png. Copy the crate09.fbx and the thumbnail.jpg files into the folder. close your project folder. Open the config.txt file. You will see two lines of text known as tags, CUID and kind. The asset CUID is a unique number for the asset. It has two parts. The first part is your Trainz identifier number. Mine is 431633. The second part is a unique number assigned to this asset. The asset kind must be one of N3V Games' supplied asset kinds. Let's call the crate scenery, as it is an object to be placed in the train scene. Change unknown to scenery. There are many tags you can add to the config file that will provide information about the asset or determine how the asset will appear and behave in Trainz. Here we will only add those that are essential. The trainz-build number is a unique number given to each train release. I have decided to use a trainz-build number of 4.6. This should allow the asset to be imported into Trainz 2019 and newer versions such as Trainz 2022. Add the text as shown. Username is the English name of the asset that will appear in the Content Manager, Surveyor Mode, and the Download Station. Add the text as shown. Category Class defines what the asset is or is used for. In older versions of Trainz, at least, it could be used to search for assets on the download station. I'm going to use BB, which indicates that the asset is a buildable object. Add the text as shown. Mesh-table-lod-transition-distances defines the distances from the viewing point at which copies of the asset with fewer poly counts will appear. The crate has only 138 polys, so one mesh will suffice. However, a mesh-table-lod-transition-distances tag must still be added. I've set the distance to 10,000 meters, at which point the cube will disappear. Add the text as shown. In addition to tags, the config file has what is known as containers. Containers have multiple lines of text with indents that are defined by brackets. The structure is important. For each opening bracket, there must be a closing bracket. The mesh table container inputs the information contained in the FBX file. So the name of the FBX file must be entered into the mesh table. The name of the FBX file is entered with a suffix trainz mesh. An autocreate value of 1 tells Trainz to make the asset visible in game. If a value of 0 is entered, the asset would be invisible in game. The LOD level is the level of detail this particular copy of the mesh represents. In the case of the crate, there is only one FBX file, and therefore only one level of detail. The first level of detail, or LOD, is designed as 0. Add the text as shown. The thumbnail container includes the information about the thumbnail image, its width, height, and name. Add the text as shown. This is the essential information needed to create an asset and import it into Trainz. Save and close the config.txt file. After entering and saving the information into the config.txt file, the changes must be submitted for edit, a process whereby Trainz compiles the information and creates the asset. In the Content Manager, select the asset, which should say it is open for edit, and submit the edits. Right mouse button and select Submit Edits. If all goes well, that is, if you have no errors, the status of the asset should change from Open for Edit to Modified. The asset is now ready to import into Trainz. Open Trainz and open or create a root. Select the Object tab, type in the name or a portion of the name of the asset to locate the asset in the list. Select the Add icon, if it is not already selected, and place the asset in the scene. To export the asset to N3V's game's download station, additional tags should be added to the config file. The category region tag defines the part of the world to which an asset would be found. For example, AU for Australia, US for the United States, or CA for Canada. The category era tag defines the time period by decades to which the asset applies. For example, 2000s or 2010s. If more than one decade is relevant, they are separated by a semicolon. The description tag contains a brief description of the asset. This will appear in the Content Manager when the asset is selected and double-clicked. It will also appear in N3V Games Download Station. The author tag is the name you use with N3V. Although this tag is optional, it is a good idea to include. For example, it allows Trainz users to contact you through the forum. The contact email tag is also optional, but gives a direct means for users to contact you. You might wish this if you want them to get specific permission to modify your assets. A licensing statement is optional, but gives you a chance to indicate how you would like your asset to be used by other Trainz users. For example, you may not wish the asset to be offered for sale. Although keep in mind that by uploading the asset to N3V Games Download Station, you are already giving N3V the right to use, even sell, your asset. You may not wish the asset to be modified. Most creators do this by removing the FBX file from the asset. Once the Trainz mesh file has been created, the FBX file is no longer needed as part of the asset. However, it would be nice if more creators left the FBX asset in the folder. The model could then be loaded back into Blender so that one could see how it was made. The texture files, as a rule, are not removed from the asset, and thus users are able to reskin assets.